She represents the opposite of Adam, really. That's exactly what it is. It's actually pretty, once you know these things, you can see it very clearly in the story. So like I said, Adam, his job is to name the animals. So what does Eve do? She listens to the animals. That's one way to see it. So why is she talking to the snake? This is a question nobody asks themselves, which is interesting. People sometimes say, wait, why is this snake talking in the story? Because that's obviously an anomaly. I mean, snakes don't talk, right? So why is the snake talking? But the real question they should be asking themselves is, how can Eve understand the snake? How does Eve know how to understand what the snake is saying? Because that's what Eve has. Adam, it has the ability to name the animals. So this is what you are, this is what you are. And it's a general, it's a way to symbolize the general idea of assigning meaning to things, imposing meaning upon things. And what Eve does is she does the opposite. She mediates with the earth, that means with matter that has no meaning or that has not been given meaning, and also with things that Adam has named, but that are not satisfied with the meaning that Adam has given. So we can actually think that that's what the snake is up to a little bit in the story. So it represents basically, so we can say Eve is mediating the perspective of the earth or of nature. So it's actually, this story is really, really deep.